everyone, today we are going to discuss about consignment accounts. After watching this video, you should be able to understand the concept of consignment and also it will help you to get familiarized with special items concerning consignment transactions. Okay, so let's start. Okay, then what is consignment? Okay, let me explain this concept with an example. Suppose there are two persons, Mr. X and Mr. Y. And Mr. X is doing business in Delhi and he wants to sell his goods in Bangalore. And all of you know that today's business environment are very competitive. Market size is increasing. So for a manufacturer or for a wholesaler, it's very difficult to come in direct contact with the customers. Especially the customers are at distant places. So here our Mr. X is want to sell his goods in Bangalore. Okay. So here Mr. X want to increase his sales, he want market penetration, but he has not any other contacts in Bangalore, he doesn't have any branches there, okay. So what happens here is, Mr. X will appoint Mr. Y as an agent. That is, Mr. X will send goods to Mr. Y and then Mr. Y will sell those goods on behalf of Mr. X. And for selling those goods, Mr. Y will get commission from Mr. X. Now see here, there are two persons involved, Mr. X and Mr. Y. Mr. X is called principal here and Mr. Y is called agent. And in consignment, we would say principal as consigner. In other words, the person who consigns the goods is known as consigner. And we call agent as consignee. In other words, the person to whom the goods are consigned will be known as consignee. Okay. So here consignee means the person who receives the goods and sell it on behalf of Mr. X. And this principal agent relationship or the entire process is known as consignment. That is, here Mr. X is transferring his goods to Mr. Y. So actually goods transferred is known as consignment. We need to remember some of the points here. Consignment of goods is not a sale. It's a mere transfer of possession of goods. Okay. That is, Mr. X sent goods to Mr. Y means only the transfer of goods. Only the transfer of physical possession of goods. Okay. And the second thing you have to remember is the consignee sells goods on behalf of consignor. For that, the consignee will get commission. And the third thing, the entire sales proceeds belongs to the consignor. That is, whatever sales proceeds will be received by Mr. Y need to be remitted to Mr. X. Now you just go through these definitions. What you mean by consignment? When goods are sent by the owner or the principal to his agent or any other representative on the condition of selling goods on his behalf, for which the latter will be given commission at a specified rate as remuneration, it is called consignment. And what you mean by consignor? He is the person who sends goods to the agent for the purpose of sale, is called consignor or the principal. And who is consignee? That is, the person to whom goods are sent on consignment is called consignee. Okay, so that's about consignment. Now let's see some terminologies related to this concept. First one is pro forma invoice. It's a statement containing all information about the goods sent. It's just like an invoice. That is, it includes information related to quantity, quality, price, etc. So this statement is prepared by the consignor. Remember, pro forma invoice is prepared by consignor and sent with goods dispatched to consignee. Next is account sales. It's a statement sent by consignee to the consignor. It contains the details regarding goods received, sales made, expenses incurred, commission charged, remittances made, and the balance due by him to the consignor. Next is commission. Commission means the remuneration payable to the consignee for sales made by him. There are three types of commission. That is, first one, simple commission, second, overriding commission, and third one is del credere commission. In the case of simple commission, usually this is a fixed percentage on total sales. So generally there will be an agreement between the consignor and consignee. So this commission is calculated as per terms laid down by the consignor. Okay. Second is overriding commission. This is the extra commission. Extra commission in the sense that if the consignee achieves a specific sales target or his sales revenue exceeds a specified amount, he will get extra commission. Sometimes the consignee is asked to promote a particular product or sell a product at a higher price. In all these cases, the consignee will get extra commission. For example, in insurance industry, the agent will get extra commission if he produces more premium volume in a given geographic territory. So overriding commission is the additional commission or extra commission. Okay. It is also calculated on total sales. And the third category of commission is del credere commission. Normally, what's happened in consignment transitions, the consignee will not take risk. That is, the consignee sells goods at the risk of the consignor. That is, the consignee is not responsible for any loss or destruction of goods held by him. Okay. But if the consignee agrees to meet any loss which is due to bad debts, he will charge an extra commission. That is called del credere commission. Or del credere commission normally related to credit side. So it is a type of commission which a consignor offers to the consignee who guarantees the collection of payment from credit customers. And it is paid to the consignee in addition to his ordinary commission. That is, here the consignee is taking responsibility of bad debts. Okay. And it is usually allowed in the case of credit sales. Generally, it's also calculated on total sales. Total sales means that is the sum of cash sales and credit sales. Okay. These are the three types of commission. Next term is expenses. While talking about expenses, it's bifurcated into two, that is direct expenses and indirect expenses. What is direct expenses? It's also called non-recurring nature. Non-recurring means not repeating. That is, this type of expenditure will occur only one time. So normally these expenses will occur between the period of goods sent by the consignor to received by the consignee. That is, all expenses incurred till the goods reach to the consignee. Okay. Say for example, freight, carriage, insurance, loading and unloading charges, etc. Next is indirect expense, also called recurring expense. Recurring means it's repeating nature. So these expenses incurred after the goods reach the consignee's godown. That is, these expense paid by the consignee after receiving the consigned goods. Okay. See, for example, godown rent, storage charges, advertisement expenses, salaries of salesmen, etc. Next is advance. That is, here the consignor may ask the consignee to deposit some money as a security in respect of the goods sent by him on consignment. It's usually a certain percentage of the value of goods sent on consignment. For example, if the value of goods sent on consignment is ₹60,000, the consignee is asked to deposit 10% of the value of goods to be sent. So the amount of advance would be 6,000. Consignment accounting, you need to prepare three accounts. That is consignment account, consignee account, goods sent on consignment account. Here consignment account is a nominal account, consignee account is a personal account, and goods sent on consignment account is a real account. Alright, so far we have discussed the meaning concept of consignment, the two parties involved in the consignment process, that is the consignor and the consignee. The consignor is also called principal and the consignee is agent. There is a principal-agent relationship, and we have also seen the important terminologies related to consignment account, that is pro forma invoice, account sales, commission, expense and advance. That's all for today. Thank you for watching.